Turning now to your questions. First up, a viewer asked us about financing options.
Can you explain the pros and cons of using a convertible debt structure to expand a small but profitable business?
All right, Ryan, let's start out by defining what a convertible debt structure is.
Well, first and foremost, convertible debt is a form of debt or financing that converts to equity. And, you know, to answer the question directly, the pros are that sometimes you don't have to give up as much equity. The cons are that you have a debt infrastructure over your head, so you have to have repayment on that at some point. I use those in a number of venture finance deals that I've been involved with, both as a CEO and as an investor. So I think it's a great instrument, and it aligns both the investor and the entrepreneur together.
So you're in favor of it?
Yes, absolutely.
One viewer wrote us asking, I'm having a difficult time deciding which type of advertising to use for my business. Is the Yellow Pages still a good choice? It seems to be affordable, but I wonder who's using it? Is anyone using it?
Yeah, I don't think I picked up a Yellow Pages in the past 10 years since the internet
was invented. Hence the younger audience thing, it's not you.
Yeah, I'm younger, and there's the only way you catch me picking up the Yellow Pages is if my PDA didn't work or there was no internet anywhere to be found. So I would say advertise on the internet before Yellow Pages, personally.
If you're trying to reach Ryan, don't go to the Yellow Pages.
Yeah,
okay.
Absolutely.
One more. Sharon Elton wants to know, how do I figure out how much to pay myself? You guys both own your own businesses. How did you figure this out?
Well, at first it was very easy. The answer was nothing.
Nothing. Yeah.
But you know, as we grew, the key is you want to pay yourself a fair salary. But at the same time, you know you're going to be able to take distributions at the end of the year. So I would be conservative and not overdo it.
I always focus on equity. So whenever I invest in a company, I pay myself according to a market-based wage, and then I take equity. And I would prefer equity because I'm, you know, invested in the long term over cash off the table now.
If you do want a salary, though, I imagine you should just go out and get comps from people.
It's tough. As a CEO, your comps can range anywhere from a million a year to, you know, nothing. So if you're an entrepreneur, it's hard to give yourself a good comp. So you just want to give yourself a good market wage and something that you can live comfortably off of.
Okay. All right. Dipping into the business cards. All right. This one is good for you guys. Should I be marketing on network sites like MySpace or Facebook? What do you think?
I think the answer is yes. It's a huge audience that are using these sites, and there are a variety of them out there. And you can get to a lot of people without spending a lot of money. That's always good.
Yeah, and you know, it's almost free marketing in many cases, but I would focus on the demographic and the audience that you're looking to connect to. There are a number of different social networks out there. There are new social networks that arise every single day.
Mm-hmm.
So I wouldn't say it's always Facebook or MySpace, but there's business-oriented social networks that are good marketing tools.
So really look around to see where your market is.
I would put them up everywhere where you could drive traffic to your business, because I think social networks are going to change the nature of the internet, so I would invest time in marketing through them.
So you guys know a lot about this. Does that take a lot of work? It's not just a matter of putting a page up, right? You actually have to be involved with it, or no?
Well, there's interactive components to them. So unlike a brochure website where you're just stating who you are, you're actually now connecting to your audience base, which is why social networks have taken off. So there's a lot more time involved, but the tools of social networks and the templates are really easy to use, and an entrepreneur can do it themselves in many cases.
Absolutely, and with the amount of traffic that you can get without having to spend money to acquire it, it will pay off if you put time in.
Okay.
Yeah.
The next card. Can I give my prospective employees drug tests? Do you want to be hiring these employees?
I mean, the answer is yes. If it's part of your hiring process, then you can. I think it just depends on your business and if that's a priority for you.
Security and different companies that are security related do require drug tests.
Mm-hmm.
In one of our companies, we worked with the military, and it was required that all of our employees take tests just to engage in that contract. So the answer is depending on the severity. If you have people operating vehicles, if you have people operating aircraft and so forth, then yes, you do need to test them.
Would there be any reason not to? Let's say you don't have that kind of company and you are just a small business and you don't want any drug addicts there, but might you turn some people off if you say, welcome to the job interview, here, it's a cup.
If they're turned off by it, you probably don't want them anyway.
Right. So, you think they're hiding something?
And perhaps you would just ask them if they would be okay with it and then see if they come back for the second interview. that would determine.
All right. Yeah. Okay. Stephanie and Ryan, stay around because we're going to bring you back for the elevator pitch.
Excellent.
Thanks, JJ.
Thank you.